Kasi ito.
Gawa na.
Teka, check ko yung A8.
Derivation.
Yung cost of production problem kasi nasa 41, di ba? Pagkatapos na yun, yung derivation lang ng equation ng hyperbola, which, so, dapat, I think, ginawa natin itong 43, di ba? Na yung from the definition of the hyperbola na yung difference of distances is a constant. And then, if you start from there, lalabas yung equation ng hyperbola. Tama? Okay. So,
Opo.
Ngayon nagawa natin yan. Yung starting point natin yun, limits. So may mga ano eh, may mga additional functions dito sa section 1.1 na Opo. Na inintroduce. Kasi after section 1.1, yung functions and their graphs, operations, I think yung limits would be in chapter 1 na rin eh. So punta na tayo sa chapter 1 ng TC7. Kasi ngayon nakita mo na yung conic sections. So, balikan lang natin yung functions and limits. Tapos yung idea ng domains and ano. Na-introduce na ba sa, na-encounter mo na ba yung interval notation for domains and ranges?
Yung ano po, yung parang bracket
ma square bracket. At saka yung open close bracket. Teka. Okay, so tingnan mo sa ano, yung illustration 1 sa page 2 ng TC7. So hindi ko na, kasi na-encounter natin yung definition ng functions before. So we'll look at some illustrations. So dito, gumagamit siya ng interval notation for ano yung domain ng y equals x square. So, tingnan mo illustration 1.
English.
Papakita ko. Figure 1 mo.
Hindi, illustration 1.
So, baba pa. Baba pa.
Yung ejemplo ilustrativo uno. Yan. So tingnan mo yung function na y equals x square. Yung domain, yung negative infinity to infinity. Shorthand siya for this notation. Teka, i-share ko lang yun. Yung share ko ng screen ko. Para teka, share ko lang yung screen. Tapos, ito yung background natin. Hala. Teka ha, sorry. Ayun. Ayan ang hirap pag black yung pen eh. Eto. So, yung infinity minus infinity to infinity. This is shorthand for yung may notation na x tapos such that
x is
between so x is such that x is an element of the real numbers or yun eh.
Technically which one po is shorthand? Pwede naman po r na lang ilalagay.
Oh, or r lang, di ba?
Opo.
Yung next na notation, yung 0 to plus infinity. So ito, shorthand lang siya for x greater than 0. Tapos, since may close interval siya, included yung 0. Ngayon, paano kapag, so ito yung range nung, so this one, yan yung range ng y equals x square. Tapos ito yung domain. Kasi all possible values are allowed, pero only this range of values are produced when you plug in x. Okay, yung next illustration, yung y equals square root of x minus 2.
So, wala yung, ano, yung difference between range and domain.
Sorry, yung?
Difference po between range and domain.
Between range and?
Domain po.
Hindi ko alam yun. Hindi ako familiar dun sa terminology na codomain eh.
Okay. Pero parang, I think it's similar to range daw po. Pero yung mga articles, they seem to say na the codomain is much different from range. But I don't really see the difference.
Hindi ko na alam. Unless may makita, ano yan eh. Gagamitin ko na yung terminology, depends ako on yung book na ginagamit eh. So okay. Since hindi hinihingi ng book natin, I'm not going to use the codomain.
Okay.
Tapos, yung ibang mga books rin na na-encounter ko, hindi naman gumagamit din ng terminology na codomain eh. But, siguro may applications siya na hindi pa natin na-encounter lang.
Okay.
Okay, so ito yung first example. Second, yung y equals square root of x minus 2. So, ano domain nito?
For real numbers po yung anything greater than or equal to 2.
So in interval notation, so pwedeng patingin naman.
Square bracket 2 to positive infinity.
So square bracket and then?
2 to positive infinity.
Okay, yung and then yung ano dito, close bracket, square bracket or open bracket? Or
yung parenthesis po.
Ito. Okay. Ngayon, so yung next example, ano yan?
Bakit pa wala po yung convention is to use open bracket po yung parenthesis when you use, when it's infinity. It's like symbolism for it will never reach infinity.
Kasi yung ano, yung close bracket, that means included yung endpoint. Pag infinity, wala naman talaga siyang endpoint eh. So, close brackets include the endpoint. Since infinity is, at least sa the real numbers, infinity is not a point. Diba? Kasi may dalawang possible, may ano yan eh. So, it's not thought of as a point kasi you can keep on moving away from that. Okay, so yan yung sa ano, no? So yan yung domain. Yung range.
Range from square root of 2 to positive. Yes ba?
So close bracket square root of 2.
No. Ano ba? Close bracket 0.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, you have to positive infinity. Oh, sige. So now that we've seen some examples, ito yung, let's look at some questions na pinapa-examine yung domain and range. Ah, no, before we do that, ganito, yung introduce ka yung definition of a function as ordered pairs. As a set of ordered pairs. So, yung ano niyan, yung model natin dito for two numbers is a point on a plane, di ba? May x, y. Yung a function is for each x or for every x, there exists only, so for every x, sorry, dapat ayoko ng notation yun. For every x, there is in the domain, kasi yung domain may set tayo nun, di ba? In the domain, there is a unique value of y associated in the range. So, examples ng yung ano, an example of a function na defined using ordered pairs. What if yung universe natin ganito? It's made up of two points, of three points. 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1. So, this set of points on the xy plane is a function.
Okay.
Na ang domain ay yung numbers 2, 3, 4. Tapos yung range is just 1. Kasi pwedeng ganyan siya, ayan eh. So it's possible to have functions like this or functions defined on integers only or functions defined on... So ito, yung next example. This is an is a non-example of a function. Bakit? Ba't hindi function tong set na to?
Kasi umuulit po si domain. Okay, so it's a mean may there's one value of the domain that has two ranges, so that doesn't make sense.
So ito yung so hindi pwede na for 2 na ma-map to both 1 and 3. Di ba?
Should be a bidirection only.
Okay, so yung technical term for the set for a set of ordered pairs lang na walang ganyang restriction, it's going to be a relation rather than a function. Okay, ngayon ito. A function is invertible. So, invertibility. So, a function is invertible if, let's say, meron kang set of points x, y. So, ganito na lang. Tapos, ang characteristic niya ay, for each x, there is one, there is a unique y. Or for each x, there is... for each y, sorry. So for each value in the domain, there is a unique x. A unique value of y. So, ito function yan. Ngayon, pag sinabi natin, what if may additional condition? For each value of y, there is just one value of x. So, pag ganito, ang tawag dyan invertible kasi pwede kang mag-reverse eh. X goes to y. And then the second condition guarantees na if you know y, you can go back to x. So example no ano, nung so let's make an example. 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5. So ito, if I know na yung value ng y ay 2, isa lang yung possible na magiging point associated. Ito lang. So for each value of y, isa lang yung x. Okay. So now that we've talked about that, punta tayo sa isang sa mga exercises para na makita mo yung makakita na yung sample. So please look at number 1. So page 10, number 1. So for each example, for each set of points, yung ano, yung notation na to, you can read it as, pag meron kang ganitong notation, ibig sabihin, this is a point, yung bar na ganyan, that means such that, so all points x, y, such that or that satisfy the condition. So for example, yung first na, no, x equals square root of x, no, y equals square root of x minus 4. Or satisfies the condition. And then, ito yung condition. Okay, so that's how you read it. So, tingnan mo yung number 1, A, B, C, D. Tapos, identify alin dyan yung, if the set, so yung curly brackets say that this is a set. Tapos, i-identify mo kung ano yung, kung function ba or hindi. And then, if it is a function, anong domain. So, stop sharing muna ako para makita ko yung ginagawa mo. So, number 1 sa page 10. Pwede mong gamitin yung Desmos to graph the function or sorry, to graph the condition. Hindi siya pwedeng yung condition kasi hindi function, di ba? So if you just want to graph it. Yeah, yung number 1. So yan yung set point set. Determine if it's a function, and then if it is a function, what's the domain? Kahit hindi mo graph, kung kaya mong makita ko ano dapat yung sagot without graphing, okay lang.
Test. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
So, a function or not? That is the question now. Okay, so function, yes.
So in condition, for every value of x, there is just unique one value of y.
Unique value of y. Yes, if it's a function, then write the domain. If it's not, then stay it. So let x be negative or not a function. Ano bang tawag nito? Condition. I don't know. Relation? Yes.
Sabihin mo lang kung not a function or function. Ano uli yung definition ng function? Just to check, for each value of x,
there must
we
be
can
a
find value of y.
Ah, wait. Ano ba yung ano dito? So, doesn't okay, so doesn't have, the y value doesn't have to be the same kasi pwede na lang ganda yung function.
So, for each value of x, may isang y lang. Pwede mo i-graph. Kung gusto mong makita yung ano niya. So, y equals square root of x.
Ah, okay. So, it's like a hyperbola.
So, square root of x squared minus 4. Okay. Tapos, ang condition ay, for every x, there's only one value of y.
Pero nag vice versa po. Kasi na have to be na for one value of y, there must be one x.
Oo.
Okay. So, function pa rin ito.
Function pa rin yan. Okay. So, yung next. Sorry. Before that, yung domain.
Ano po na, gagamit ko pa yun dyan.
Yung interval notation. Tapos, so minus infinity all the way to okay. Close. Union.
So, it seems so na to positive infinity, negative. Okay, tama.
Sige. So, yung next?
Parang baliktad naman siya. So, right. 4 minus 4. 0.
Hindi, ganito. Ano yung condition na dapat na para maging well-defined yan?
Para maging ano po? Function?
Everybody or para, hindi, para maging, hindi, I mean, para maging well-defined yung expression na yan. What what inequality does x must satisfy?
The radicand must be positive. So,
4 minus x squared okay. Is?
4 minus x squared is equal to 0. So, x squared is equal to 4. Okay, greater than...
Diba, ganito, it's, di ba, kailangan natin yung loob positive. So write that down. 4 minus x square is greater than or equal to 0. Ngayon, naalala pa ba yung method for dealing with quadratic inequalities?
X is less than negative 2 and x is greater than 2 po?
yung ano, nala, yung factor and then make a table of signs.
Okay.
So 2 minus x times 2 plus x and then make a table of signs of each factor.
Ah, okay. So maligal sa table of signs na is so dito para sa ayla. So negative therefore negative 2 is negative 2. This is negative 2, yes.
Okay, or in interval notation?
Interval notation? Ah, domain na pala to. Tama pala.
Okay, so yan ang domain. So function siya.
So far, wala naman pong not a function. I hope this one is not a function, so it will be something. X plus y squared equals 4. Circle. So, definitely not. Okay, not a function. I knew it.
Okay, kasi for each value of y, may dalawang possible values of x, di ba? Ah, sorry, for each value of x, may dalawang possible values of y. So, yung test dito ay draw a vertical line. Tapos may dalawang intersections. Okay. So, tingnan natin yung number three.
Instructions. I will find a way to transcribe this. The translate can translate it for me. I can move it now. Wow. Great powers. No! Okay, the power of screenshotting. You didn't... Wait, I will separate them. This genius. Okay, so there's one here, and then there will be another one here. Someone changed the aspect ratio for some reason. There. Then someone changed the aspect ratio again. Why are the bars not aligned? No. The ball.
Sir, nadidinig po kami?
Okay. So, by the way.
Okay. X squared. Definitely not a, yeah, definitely a function. I'm sorry. When is it not a function? Oh, this is not a function. Easy. I mean, technically, it is a function, but it's not a function of X.
And then, remember, yung condition niyan ay it gives you points on the plane. Does this set of points satisfy the conditions for a function? Now, for every X, there is only one Y.
For this one, oh, yes. There's only one Y at all times.
Teka, ano ba graph ng X equals... okay, so for Y equals X square function. Okay, sige. Tapos yung X equals Y square.
So, obviously, daming vertical lines.
So, yan. So, diba? So, not function. Okay. Domain.
Real.
Okay.
Remember pong better way to write the code speed. Not a function. No domain. Okay, what did I even think of? Function. Yes, obviously, because it's a function. Polynomial, okay.
Okay, so domain is, okay.
And it should look too bad. Like I'm missing something. Okay, so domain that, okay. And then not a function.
Pwedeng pahigraph
on this wait. Boss. Hold on. Hold on. How does the X cube look like? Oh, it looks like that. Okay, so it looks like this. So it's a function. Let me test. -1, -4, -6. Okay. One more field.
Okay, so function okay. Or not?
The function.
Tapos right. Ano domain? So, okay. So, it's still all R. Sige. Yung... Okay. So, function notation. You probably encountered this already. So, pang-check lang. Number 5. Given f of x is equal to 2x minus 1, find the following.
Like, I did this before already, pero I don't remember. Or I don't know where I placed it. Or I did this before. It captured. Okay. No. Select.
Tapos yung sagot mo lang, sagot mo ABC, pabaong.
Like that is like given. Okay. Given this one's not this one. Determine something. Okay. So pan calculator. Five. Four.
Zero.
Two. Okay.
One.
Okay. Seriously, what is the label trying to tell me? He just changed the variables. A plus 1 became X plus 1. Okay.
Teka, may mali. Sorry. Hindi mo sayang. Gusto ko i-check, no? Paano mo winner count? F of X plus 1 is equal to?
Oh wait a minute. I forgot that X is actually a real it's something that's a real significance. instead of being just a variable like lonely. So, wait. X plus 1. 2x plus... Oh, it's the exact same thing. Okay.
So, f of the quantity x plus 1 equals 2.
Ah, still the same.
Yeah.
Okay. F2 plus x4 x squared minus 1. And then g 2fx...
Wait. Yung f... Pwedeng i-check mo yan. Ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng f of 2 of x?
F 2 x mo?
Mm-hmm.
F 2 times x. So, ah, 4x. Because naging 2x to. Okay.
Uh-huh.
And then dito, 4x pa rin.
Ito natin yung buo na.
Okay.
Ah, sige, okay na yun. Pwede na. So, yung sa G?
Pwede na, right? 1, 2, H, and then H, 2, X plus H. 2X plus H. Equals 2X. Sometimes I question, why do I even expanded out of factor form. And then 2x, okay, 2x plus 2h minus 2. Okay. And then j is y. Why did he make this? Okay, I know some of them already. Haha. Checkmate later. I'm using the previous example.
Pwedeng patingin niya. Huwag kang... Pwede pakita mo yung substitution and then yung simplification.
Ah, okay. So...
So, close quantity. So, open... So, square brackets.
Square...
Minus.
Divided by... Okay, so this is equal to blah 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 2. Why did it make it comma? Why? Another hassle. Equals 2h over 8 equals to 5. Nice. Done. And then the page is going to end soon.
Okay, so we're done with number
5.
So number 7 naman.
Given that something is something, do this. How long does this go on? 9? Oh, it ends at 9. Okay, nice.
Okay, ngayon tingnan mo yung ano, no? May tinatanong dyan yung pansin mo na for 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, yung letter F, pare-pareho ng pinapakompute.
I think it's
or yung to last tell- letter. Bakit kaya? Can you guess?
It's trying to tell that maybe it's possibly equal to 2 all the time. Possibly. Or something. It's equal to something. So, fx plus h. So, lahat ng mga variable manaduplicate except yung constant.
Gaito.
Yes.
Pag binigyan ka, for example, x to the 7th.
Oh, x
to the 7th. So ito, subukan mo to. Let f of x be equal to f x to the 7th. So ano yung f of x plus h minus f of x over h? Pwedeng pa patingin ng ano kung yung lalabas. So let f of x be so x to the 7th. Tapos ang pinapakompute sa ay the quantity f of x plus h minus f of x over h. So ano kaya yan? Okay, substitute.
Wait a minute. I feel like I've seen this before. It's like derivative? Something to do with calculus. Yes. Parang it's a thing like h is like the epsilon or something.
Mm-hmm. Tapos yung interest natin ay tingnan yung behavior niya.
So let's say may function nga po, some function. There is f of x here, f of x h. So
mag-compute tayo ng gradient.
Ah, so you're trying to find this. Okay, so the labels already telling us the derivative without even knowing it.
So related siya sa derivative. Pero approximation siya. The approximation only gets better when you take the limit. Na yun yung patutunguhan natin eh. Kaya siya binibigay na ganyang exercises para pag pina-set up sa yung get the derivative from the definition. Hindi ka na problem sa substitutions na ganyan.
Opo.
Okay. So balik na tayo dun sa ano, sa yung last number na ginagawa mo.
Dada, something. Okay, so given something missing, substitute everything and then compute for that. Okay. Ow! These are the papers that give me paper. Okay, so...
Yeah.
Two negative two. Okay, I cannot mental everything anymore.
X
is too long.
Square plus 5x minus 3. Tapos negative 1 to 3.
Okay, nothing everything.
Okay, so pag negative 1, pwedeng pa-recheck. 2 times 2 minus 5 minus 3. Sorry, negative 2 ba yan?
Obo, negative 2.
Ah, okay, sige. Okay, so continue with B and...
Peace.
Okay. Pwedeng pwedeng huwag kang tumalo ng ano, pwedeng i-step by step mo siya.
So parang lalagay ka po ulit yung sa ko. H plus 1 square. Here. La.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, okay. Ngayon yung just before that, yung pag-expand out and grouping, gusto ko lang makita.
Just before this? Ano po yung before
this? Hindi, yung last line.
Ah, last
yung
line.
Just before the last line, may ano dyan, may steps na nangyari.
Ah!
So, 2h square plus
equals yes.
So, 4h plus 5h is
4h plus 5h is equal to 7h. Basic arithmetics.
And then 5, 6, 7 minus 3. Okay, that's going to be 4. Okay, so yung next.
Okay, so magagawa.
Nee, gawin mo yung substitution. Gawin mo in detail yung substitution. Wag don't skip yung mga steps.
Me after in detail. Where is the square? 2x.
Kasi isipin mo, you're writing not just for yourself but for someone else. So 2 square is 4, so 8. Mm-hmm. Plus 'yung okay. So same thing, yung detailed na 2 times x, di ba x square minus 3? Tapos yung x square, yung first term, tingnan mo yung ano. kaya, pwedeng iulong mo yung H pababa. Para may, ano yan eh. Remember, you're using virtual paper. So, hindi dapat concern yung blank spaces. In fact, yung blank spaces make it more readable.
bottled often.
Okay, so hindi na siya simplify po ba yan? So, parang wala na, di ba?
There's no, not, there's nothing to simplify. I think this would look bad. Okay, the notebook then. My notebook, but it keeps falling apart every second I use. Okay, then I, and then A should be here. Okay, looks better. And then I is simply adding. Okay, easy.
Tiga yam. Tinatry kong pwede patingin mo ano, nasa yung F of H. Meron na ba? Ah, okay, wala. So 2x squared plus 5x minus. Tiga. Wait. Saan ang galing yan uli?
From a listing.
Pwede nga, no? Pakita mo step by step.
Why?
Tapos maglagay ka ng use parentheses. Kasi, di ba? Yung isa, teka, yung letter I, ang pinapahanap ay F of X plus F of H.
So
tapos
have...
bakit magkaiba yung ano na minus 6? Di ba minus 3 din yun? Dapat yan?
Nagkaano lang po yung confusion from yung kanina answer.
Okay, so...
And then J, baka lang dito. It's a middle ground.
Yeah. Make a new page na.
Okay. Wala pala akong new page.
Actually, tingnan mo yung icon na may plus, green plus.
Ito mo?
Oo. Click mo lang. Tapos mag-new page na siya.
So, okay, there's a shortcut all this time.
Tapos, ayan.
Basta move this. Single. Or more likely, I should just screenshot this.
Ne, mas madaling copy. Pwede kang mag-copy dyan.
Okay.
Yung screenshot kasi mga photo eh. Okay, so yung F of X plus H minus F of X over H. So just show the details.
Why? This is the most painful part of every problem. Where's the Mr. H? Okay, here. So I'm a copy you. And then it's not as simple as I think it would be to copy some others. Okay, it's only that one. Good. So back here. And then erase this. Yes, fixed. I will need a more space.
Yeah. Gamit ka ng close bracket. Or i-bracket mo siya para clear na yung part niya. Yan yung F of X plus H. Minus.
All over X, but I fear I won't be able to draw that well. So...
Okay, and then simplify.
I'll tell how I can use it. That's it.
Plus
I mean,
2a. Ah, wait. Plus 5. Okay. Sige.
Seems correct. And then, ayan,
just to check. Wait. Before you go. Before you go to the next step. Ano limit as h approaches 0?
As h approaches 0, 4x plus 5. That is the
derivative.
Derivative. Cancel the sum of 5. Okay.
So 4x plus 5. Okay. So number 9.
Okay. Number 9. What are you? Given something. Okay, now there are only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are only six some problems. What? Oh, okay. Four, five, five. By true.
Ayun, pakita mo na yung substitutions para malinaw paano mo nakuha yung mga yan. Alam mo kung bakit inaano ko yung practice na pakita mo yung details? Kasi darating yung point na pwedeng mas mahaba pa yung expressions eh. Tapos hindi na kaya ng short-term memory na itrack. So it's a good habit na pinapakita mo yung detail.
Opo.
So, square root of...
Ah, okay. And then...
Okay. Ay, pakita mo na yung substitution.
Oh, running out of time again? Bro. Corporate Zoom as always.
Okay.
Principal, okay, ito na. What is Lethal trying to tell?
Yeah, square root of x square is not x.
Ah, plus remember?
Minus. Yeah, hindi siya plus or minus x. Isang value lang yan. So, for example, if x is negative 9, ano yung value dapat ng function?
value ng function.
So, ganito. Sulat mo yung f of x squared minus 9. Ayan. So, absolute value fix.
That's why it's not x, because if it's negative, it'll stay negative. But then, if it needs to be positive.
So, absolute value.
Is there like a negative value po yung parang absolute value, but the other way around, parang negative?
Hindi mo, hindi natin kailangan eh. Kasi maglay ka lang ng negative sign eh. Diba?
Okay. So, I don't know what label is trying to tell. X squared. Okay, it stops getting bigger. So, here, it changes.
Teka. Do you need the absolute value sign there?
I know, because like X squared is always positive. It's like redundant. Equals X plus T.
So x squared, yeah.
Oh, I don't have any ifs to copy from, so I'll have to do it from scratch. Is there any simplification here? I don't think so.
Okay na yan, no? Ngayon, paano kung kailangan mong hanapin yung limit as h approaches 0?
I don't know.
Alam natin yung sagot, di ba? Kasi dapat derivative yan. Pero if you were doing this from scratch without knowing that that's the derivative, how do you get the limit?
Mga ano ba, mga pioneers in calculus. Paano ba? I mean, okay, when it becomes zero.
May problema yan eh. Diba? Kasi nagsizero yung denominator, nagsizero yung numerator.
Lobo.
Okay, so pwedeng, so isulat mo to, limit as h approaches 0 of that. So, parang additional exercise lang. H, x is going to be fixed. Diba? Of the quantity of that quantity.
Okay.
Ngayon, that's equal to limit of instead, so dito, ang gusto kong gawin mo, i-anti-rationalize mo siya. So use the different, so multiply by square root of x plus h plus 9 plus square root of h x plus 9.
So, multiply by the conjugate po to. So anti-rationalization pala po yun, yung parang from the rationalized form. Multiply by the conjugate.
I think, wala naman tayong term, no? Pero, yun yung convenient na iname.
Opo.
Diba? Kasi, mukhang, ano yun, ibalik siya sa hindi pa na-rationalize. Pero, try that. See what happens. So, if you multiply by square root of x by the conjugate sa numerator at denominator,
I think it would be a painful piece of algebra. That's my honest opinion. Okay. Equals.
I think ano, iulong muna yung, kasi that's a separate question eh. So iulong muna yung buong yan sa baba. So, ano yung conjugate over conjugate?
Genius. Then I'll just put a plus sign.
Okay, sige, work it out. So, yung numerator magsisimplify. Because... yung denominator, huwag mong galawin.
Square, minus x plus
9
square. Okay, so
narrated
that will simplify.
Wait,
things.
Di ba may square root?
Ah, so it will become just x plus 8.
Mm-hmm. Divided by...
wait a minute, when x turns into 0, the numerator will become 0, although... ah, okay, there's a...
h times the quantity.
There is hope. There's a denominator. So...
straight of x plus 9. Tapos, ilagay mo ng parenthesis. Ayan. So, okay, see what happens.
I mean, not really matter anymore. Ah, it still matters because there's still h in the denominator. Genshin impact. Uh-huh. There.
So anong, yeah, so what happens when h goes to 0?
So x minus, no way, the derivative.
See? Okay, ngayon balik tayo dun sa ano, ano yung function na kinuha natin, derivative square root of x plus 9, diba? Yung f of x. So, ano yung derivative ng square root of x plus 9?
1 over 2.
Yeah. 1 half. And then, x plus 9 to the negative 1 half times yung derivative ng nasa loob, which is just 1. So, wow. Yan talaga siya.
Okay. Derivative po of the square root.
Okay. So, yung next question naman.
Sketch by hand the function. Sketch by hand. I will literally die. In lost error. Yes.
Ne, may mga ano yan eh. May mga functions kasi na dapat alam mo yung itsura.
46?
Na may sketch without a calculator. Tapos, may mga, yung examples ngayon dito, may mga functions na piecewise.
In the piecewise. Ah, ba't nagana ko? Difference. 11 through 46. Ipuhin.
Sketch by hand.
Ano? The graphic na.
The graph.
The function and the determine but its
domain and range.
Contra dominio. Oh, okay, so that's the range contra domain. Like the opposite of the range and the domain. Okay, so 11, 13. Wait, I need to ready a graph. Where are you now?
So number 11.
Same kind of range. Yes, all of the odd numbers.
So odd. So 11 is f of x equals 3x minus 1.
this is really epic. I can literally just draw a graph. Okay.
Teka, nag-substitute ko ba ng points or ng values ng x to get at least 2 points? Kasi line yan, di ba?
Tama.
So, choose 2 points para lang ma-determine yung meron kang ano, para meron kang specific na x na pair na xy. So, when x is 0, ano yung value ng y? Ngayon, yung mas convenient dito ay when y is 0, ano yung value ng x? So it looks like yung magandang scale ay for 1 yung 1 unit is 3 divisions. So yung 0 to 1 is may tatlong squares.
To make it a little bigger.
Tapos iulong mo yung mga function evaluations mo to one side para may space. So when x is 0, y is equal to negative 1. Teka, ganito. I-plot mo yung ano na yan. Di ba meron tayong when y is 0, x is 1/3?
Yan mo.
Okay, tapos when x is 0, okay, so yung ano yung scale mo sa vertical, yung isang division is 1. So paki-label lang. Okay, tapos ayan. Okay, so yun yan.
Nice. So napot medyo blessing talaga ko to ano itong graph na option dito. So,
okay, so domain and range.
Domain and range. Okay.
May sulat mo na as a whole word. Domain, tapos colon. Tapos use the whole word, domain, and then range. Okay, so for this one, so yun din, ano? All yields. Okay, number, yung number 13 naman. Bumaba ka, mag dun sa go below para may space. Para hindi kasi 'di ba? Remember, you have lots of space.
Infinite space.
Well, hindi naman, pero at least yung isang so new page. Ano, mag new page ka na.
Ah, okay. So parang fake open to. Ayun.
Actually, pwedeng ano yung select, i-click mo, tapos okay, so anyway, it's a new page. Okay.
Page.
Yan. Okay, so ano yung shape ng graph na yan?
Parabola.
Okay, so here, relatively simple lang naman yan. So okay na yung hindi ka ganun kaano sa sketch. So importante lang eh, nasaan yung minimum, tapos opens in what direction. Yung Y scale is not going to be that critical, it's not going to be critically important. So parabola siya. So using yung methods ng additional math, ano yung sketch mo na yung graph? And then connect the dots. Kasi hindi ganun ka-critical na lagyan mo ng scale yan. Kasi importante lang dito yung ano eh, ma-identify mo ano yung domain, ano yung range. So, ano yung domain at ano yung range? Ano yung domain, ano yung definition uli ng domain? The domain is
everything possible. Ah, okay.
And then yung range. So plus infinity. Sige. So number 15 naman.
Hello.
So 15 is g my 5 minus x square. So g pag of x equals.
Pagka pa lalagay si 15.
Then, baba na.
Dito.
So yung just below. Okay na naman yung just below eh. Ang importante lang para hindi confusing kapag binabasa. Okay, so ano yung graph niyan?
Bababa po.
Okay. Opening. Tapos ano yung maximum, ano maximum or minimum niyan?
Maximum. Ah, so 5 above po siya. Yung ano na yung maximum. Hindi maximum.
So square root of 5 is okay. Tapos when y is 0, ano-ano yung values of x? Or approximately so square root of 5 is approximately
mga 2
around 2 point something diba 2.23 So, domain and range naman. Pwedeng iulong mo sa yung domain range na lahat yan to the right para may space between the graph. Okay. Sige. So number 17 naman. Okay, ngayon, isulat mo muna yung right lattice y equals square root of x minus 1. Okay, ngayon, when you're dealing with something like that, mas madaling i-graph yan kapag in-square mo both sides. So, if you square both sides, that's y square equals x minus 1. X equals y squared plus 1. So, pag ganyan, ano yung shape ng graph niyan?
Parabola po, pero opening rightwards.
So, opening to the right. Tapos, hindi siya yung buong parabola kasi may restriction tayo because of the square root.
Opo. Positive part lang.
So pag sketch lang naman yan eh. So kailangan ko lang makita yung positive part. Tapos yung so x is equal to yeah. So when y is 0, ano yung x? When x is 2, okay. And then when y is 3, 9 plus 1 is 10. So, pag 2 minus two plus one, y is 2. Okay, x is equal to. Teka, when y is 2, ano yung value ng x? Ano may mali?
5.
Yeah. Y is 2. 2 plus 2 times 2 is 4. Okay, sige. Tama. So, okay. Ngayon, ano yung domain, ano yung range? Don't write it on the graph. I-sulat mo siya somewhere else para madaling makita. So, 1 to infinity. Range is... plus infinity. Okay. Yeah. So, we're done with 17. Let's look at 19. Okay, so 19, f of x is square root of x squared minus 4. Yan. Tapos, I think para mas mali i-graph yan, sulat mo yan as y equals square root of x squared minus 4. And then, square both sides. So, y equals square root of x squared minus 4. So, y squared equals x squared minus 4. Ngayon, yung itsura na yan, if we isolate, so from there, makukuha natin na 4 equals x squared minus y squared.
Hyperbola.
Mm-hmm.
With a equals 2, b equals 2.
Kaya inuna ko yung ano eh, yung equations, yung conic sections eh. Kasi maraming marami kang mag-graph na, ah, part 2 ng parabola, part 2 ng hyperbola, part 2 ng ellipse. And then, may practice ka na dealing with hyperbola, ellipses, and so on. Eh. So, yung important dito ay when x is 2 and minus 2, tapos yung asymptotes lang. Kasi pag alam mo na yung asymptotes, madali nang isketch yan. So, we have two vertices. Yung when x is 2, y is equal to 0. Diba? Tapos, asymptotes. So, yung asymptotes ay y equals x. Kasi pag i-pull out mo siya sa square root eh. Diba? Ayan. Okay, tapos ang kailangan lang natin dyan sa hyperbole, yung mga yung positive parts. So, i-ano mo lang siya. Just hindi mo kailangan yung actual numbers dyan. Ang kailangan lang dyan ay makita na hyperbola tapos approaching the asymptotes. Okay. We don't need yung mga negative values kasi di ba yung positive values lang eh. Yung asymptote kailangan natin. Yung plus or minus x. Oo, kailangan 'yan. Pero yung walang graph dun sa ilalim ng x-axis. Kasi yung mga yung square root, 'di ba, bibigyan na sa'yo yung positive values eh. So graph one branch on the right and then reflect it dun sa kabila. So walang graph sa ilalim kasi 'di ba y equals square root of x square minus 4. And then connect. Okay. And then yung reflected graph sa kabila. Okay na yan.
Answer po, sir.
So, and domain and range. Una, wala sa ilalim. Hindi kasama, di ba, y equals square root of x square minus 4 yan. Yung ilalim kasi, yung buong hyperbola. Pero kung y equals square root of x square minus 4, we're only dealing with the top half. Okay, so domain is... Okay, and range. Yeah. Oh, sige. Number 21. So, I think mag-new page ka na. Yung green yan.
Or maybe focus din po na parang green siya, so something good.
So, yung graph looks like the graph of a
circle.
Okay, so centered at the origin. Tapos, pero yung hindi buong circle yung mag-graph dyan.
Upper version of. I-erase ko na ako.
Okay. So ano domain, ano range? Okay, so included pareho. Sige. Teka. Meron akong gustong yung ano, pwedeng patingin ng task manager mo. Gusto ko lang makita yung kung anong kumakain sa system resources mo pag nag-tutorial tayo. Kasi yung nag-blue screen of death, minsan maano niya yun. If it's a task thing or what. So, pa-share ng task manager lang. Gusto ko lang makita kung anong... Teka, kailangan kong palakihan to. Full screen. Meron bang full screen to? 76%, no? Pwedeng patingin ng ano, nung about, ng about your system. Ano kung meron yan eh. Sa... Yung sa... Search mo sa Windows yung about. First. About your PC. Yan. Okay, so 8 gigs. Okay, sige. Ano yan? Pag, mukhang ano lang talaga yun, no? Mukhang kumakain, malapit sa mga 70% yung memory usage ninyo eh. So, mukhang malapit na kailangan nyo mag-upgrade nung RAM.
Ako.
Okay, so let's look at, so we're done with number 21. So, 23 naman.
Kasi naman yung si 23, so baka ilang seconds na to.
Oo. Actually, tingin ko mabilis lang yan eh. Kasi alam mo naman yung graph nung na-encounter na dapat natin yan sa additional math, di ba? So, saan yung critical point dyan sa absolute value of x? It happens when x is equal to Teka. Ganito, di ba absolute value, ganito. Let's write down the absolute value in na ano, yung cases. When, kapag positive yung nasa loob, x minus 3. Kapag okay. Negative yung nasa loob,
ah, super piecewise.
Oh, i-piecewise mo siya para makita mo yung behavior. So f of x is equal to x minus 3 when x is greater than 3. Tapos, so 3 minus x. Ngayon, yung pagganyan, so kailangan mo i-graph mo siya for x greater than 3. So, iulong mo lahat yan. Kasi, not enough space, di ba? Tapos, yung text na sinulat mo, move it to the right. Kaya may white space yun eh. Para pwede mong isulat yun doon. So, move it some more. So move everything more to the right. Uulong pa. Yan. So that may sapat na space yung graph mo. Okay. Anyway, since 30 seconds na lang, so iiwan ko na siya ito na go in. Tapos pakita mo sa akin yan. You can continue with the rest of this. Tapos pakita mo sa akin sa not Sunday, the next Thursday. Kasi every Thursday yung gagawin natin ng math eh. Wait, okay. Pwede mo mag-negative yung absolute value of x minus 3? Tapos useful mag-plug in ka ng values para mag-graph mo na maayos yung line. Anyway, we'll stop here. I'll see you next on Sunday. Bye-bye.